talk to you. And you know, there are a lot of good reasons to watch Twin Peaks. Here are three of them. Mm-hmm. And one of these lovely ladies is here tonight. She plays Shelley Johnson, a waitress at the Double R Diner. And she is Machen Amick. How's it going, Machen?
It's going good.
It sure is. Look at this. Let's talk about your name, first of all. I mean, how did a girl from Reno, Nevada get Machen Amick? I've been practicing all day. Did I get this right?
Yes, Machen Amick.
Because I know your director even messes up on it sometimes.
Well, he does it purposely, though.
Does he?
This is Machen, yeah.
Well, David Lynch.
Oof. It's German. My parents are German, and it means, they tell me it means pretty young maiden.
It does. It means. That's exactly.
Okay.
You are a waitress at the Double R Diner. My first question, obviously, have you ever really tasted the cherry pie?
Yes.
Did you really?
Yes, I did.
What does it taste like?
It's very good. I think it's Marie Callender's.
They bring it in just for you.
Yeah.
Gosh.
No, when we're behind the scenes, I'm eating the cherry pie, or any kind of pie.
Mm-hmm. You are so incredibly young and beautiful to have gotten this part. I mean, at age what, 19?
Yeah.
How did you do it? Because I mean, 19-year-olds across the world are saying, "Well, oh, I'd love to do that." Did you audition at home? Not in Reno, right?
No. I left when I was 16 and came down to Los Angeles and just started pounding the pavement and worked my butt off, and here I am.
Good for you. Good for you.
Thank you.
Kyle MacLachlan, it's funny, Kyle MacLachlan was on Saturday Night Live and said, "You killed Laura Palmer." Do you know that?
I was very excited.
Did you?
That I was actually mentioned on Sunday.
Did you kill Laura Palmer? You know,
it's
getting to the point, though, don't you think? I mean, as you talk to people, either David Lynch is messing with our minds a little bit here, or we're going to have to pay this thing off pretty soon. I mean, I watched last week, for example, and I'm sitting there saying, now, I'm enjoying the camera angles and the shots, and but at some point, we're going to have to resolve this thing. Are the actors saying that?
Of course.
Mm-hmm.
And we're just like the audience. We don't know who did it, so every night we watch it, it's like...
He's really into sounds. Have you noticed how much into sounds? Like, even his logo at the end with all those electrical buzz sounds and everything.
Did you notice when the hospital food, like, gurgled? Like,
yes, yes. What was that?
It was alive. I don't know.
And, wow, and Eraserhead. This first thing he did when he was a student, like a graduate student film, I mean, this thing that they reproduced gurgled and had the weird noises and all. And then I noticed that they mixed the sounds a little bit hotter than they normally would be, you know, for a regular film.
Uh-huh.
And, man.
There's David for you.
You, how's your private life? I noticed that you're engaged now.
Yes, I am.
Is it okay if we...
Oh, come on.
You see, that's... That's a downer for a lot of guys watching. Now, how long are you when you're going to get married?
We don't know. When the time... Because we know we're going to be together forever, so we don't feel that we have to rush it.
Mm-hmm. Well, you brought your fiance. Can we take a shot of it?
Yes, do.
David, is David here? David. Yes, hi, David. How you doing, man? Throw the lens on him. There you go. What a guy. Where'd you meet David?
We lived across the street from each other.
In Reno?
In Los Angeles, when I first came down. And I was gonna move into his apartment building, and he was moving out, and so we kind of moved out together.
And this was before Twin Peaks and everything, right?
Yeah.
Who is the one who has the incredible, supposedly somebody can eat a cherry and tie the cherry into a knot? It was not you really on the, on the show? Yeah.
On the show, Sherilyn Finn, Audrey Horn did it.
Right. But you can actually do that. Let's watch you in action, then give it a shot, all right? Okay, because I brought some cherries here.
Oh, good.
Now, this is you with the double R, right?
No, this is...
No, you're in the hospital. You're in the hospital. That's right. You've gone...
Last season, we ended, and I was in a burning mill. Leo tied me up and left me there. And so now you see me in the hospital. And I don't know if Bobby's dead or not. And so now he's come to the hospital, and he's obviously alive. And here we go.
I'm so afraid. Leo tried to kill me. He knows about us. He took me up to the mill. And he tied me up and started the fire. Bobby. He told me he was gonna kill you.
Bad chance. I won't let him hurt us anymore. Are you all right?
Doctors seem to think so.
You know, Shelley, hospitals are dangerous places. First of all, they're crawling with sick people. And second of all, that food can kill you. So if you want to get out of here pronto, you're going to have to let Bobby be your doctor. So, let's just have a look here, Miss, shall we?
Oh, no!
Oh, Shelly! That Bobby, man! The relationship with Bobby is purely physical. I mean, the guy is all over you in every episode. And then you're attracted to that dork. I mean, you're married to that guy. Who comes at you with a sock and soap and...
Yes, but I did explain it in last season. I said that the reason why I was with Leo was because it was better than sitting in a stupid classroom. He was a flashy guy in his hot car, so...
And you base Shelley not... obviously, this is not like you at all, Machen. This Shelley is a different lady. Who did you base her on, this character?
Well... When you're raised, your parents always try to make you to be, you want to be dominant and live your own life. And with Shelley, she has to, I'm always finding when I do scenes that I want to, you know, lash back out at Leo and set him straight, but Shelley doesn't do that. And so I knew someone in Reno that had this kind of situation. She was attracted to bad guys and they kept beating her up and she actually shot her husband, so.
That's enough motivation for you for an entire season. Yeah. That's that David Lynch type of stuff, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, we've wasted enough time. You've got to do this thing now. Has anybody ever tried this? I can't do it. I tried this when I was in Boy Scouts. I couldn't do this.
Okay. Well.
Actually, I was in a fraternity one time. I felt a thigh. And
having flashbacks, I think, please. Okay.
I'll have one.
Yes, thank you.
These are great.
Okay.
I feel like I'm on the home show. Look at this. Mmm.
Don't mmm.
Give me a little drum roll there, Billy.
No boy.
All right. Machen Amick on national television ties the stem of a maraschino cherry with her incredibly agile tongue.
I feel good. Ow! 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 Ow!
Hey, you stop that. Don't stop the drum.
Oh, keep on. Look at this. Something's going on in there. Oh my gosh! Machen Amick! Good job! And I hope you serve 5,000 more pieces of pie.
Thank you.
You're the most beautiful pie server we have ever had from the Double R.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Be right back with the London Choir Boys, Mason Amick.